it's run and breed, run and breed. Niggas wanna envy me, envy me. Niggas know it's run and breed, run and breed. Niggas wanna envy me, envy me. She a light skin John.
We're gonna catch the kids' reaction to their new sister. They haven't saw her because we're just now getting home. Camera up. Keep the camera up. She's in pain, so we gotta catch their reaction to their new sister. So we're gonna go inside.
Honey, I'm home.
For like, I think a week, probably longer than a week, but
probably like a week and a half maybe.
Yeah, but she had the baby, so you know, we had to take a little break. Yeah. And we got some situations going on in our personal life, so but we just came out to take this little nice little walk to talk to you guys and to let her get some fresh air and clear her mind. So why not talk to you guys while we do this?
So I want to tell y'all the story of what happened. So like...
Right now?
Yeah. Just walking. Just, you can still tell them. Basically y'all, I had to have a C-section. Look at the lightning bug.
I know. Ow. Look at the lightning bugs. Okay. You scared of lightning bugs?
Yeah, what if it touches me?
Lightning bugs are harmless. You never saw lightning bugs before?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Lightning bugs are bugs like in your childhood that you used to catch. Like we used to catch them in bottles and stuff and leave them in there and then they would light up. But you gotta set them free.
I never caught them. We should have took a walk to the other pool.
The other pool?
Yeah.
In your robe? I was just gonna walk around here.
Alright, so I had to have a C-section, guys. It wasn't planned. I didn't know I was gonna have one. I didn't know I had to have one. Basically, I had to get her out. I was dilating pretty slow.
We can walk over here and walk back.
Okay. I was dilating pretty slow. And it was like when I dilated, they would feel her head, but it didn't feel like she was coming down. So, things kind of got weird. Her heart stopped for a minute, like just like for a second at first when I was 7 centimeters. Mm-hmm. After I got my epidural and some type of medicine they gave me to go into labor a little quicker because my contractions was really far apart even though I was 7 centimeters, which was weird. So after that is when her heart, like, it was dropping and then it stopped for about 10 minutes. So she died in my tummy for a little while.
For like 10 minutes, she,
yeah.
For 10 minutes, her heart stopped beating. But good thing they did the emergency C-section because... What are you doing?
I'm scared.
Go away.
away.
Woo! Bae!
Come on. Anyways, like we were saying, they had to do emergency C-section because the baby heart stopped beating and she stopped breathing. So as soon as she got out, they had to take her to the breathing, to the NICU so she could start breathing again.
Yeah, like they, what happened was they turned me over.
Like a cow.
They turned me over on my hands and knees and they was trying to rock me to get her to wake up. It was like a bunch of nurses and doctors that was just rushing in. I don't know how many, it was like 20 of them in the room, and
I was just sitting there ready to deliver a baby. Yes, y'all gonna see the picture on the screen right now.
Yeah. My blood pressure kept going low. Wait, what is that?
What?
You see that bug?
It's and gonna the crack?
Hop. Yeah, it's gonna hop.
Oh, cricket.
Ew!
Okay, let's turn around. They got so many weird bugs out there.
Okay, so my blood pressure kept dropping and her heartbeat stopped. So basically, if they didn't hurry up, something could have happened to me. So we had to do emergency C-section and they rushed me. I started crying and we was in there and they strapped me down like I was some type of freaking, how you say it?
Animal?
Like a threat or something? Yeah, like I was gonna do something. I was strapped down.
Oh, you
to
was gonna
table.
Move.
They don't want you to move. What? I didn't even feel nothing. But I was strapped down. They was trying to start the C-section without him and kept telling me, yeah, he's coming, we're gonna get him. And I was like, no, I don't want anything started on me until my husband is here. I want him in the room. Can you get him? I just kept asking. I didn't care if they was getting annoyed. Like, I'm annoyed.
She said, okay, Dad, we're ready.
Yeah, like, he was all dressed. I was like, I was so, like, I felt drugged up. Like, literally, I just seen him in all white. But I didn't even give a f-. Sorry, YouTube. I didn't care. Because I was like, I don't care as long as he's right here. So he took my hand and held my hand the whole time. And he was trying to make me laugh. So he was like my pride and joy through the whole thing and kept me like.
Somebody old at an office in there.
He kept me going through the whole process and made me know that I could do it, and I did it. But then afterwards, right now I feel like I'm going through postpartum depression. So it's kind of what he means by clear my mind. I've been crying every 30 minutes lately, or just here and there when I think too much. But it's just feelings. So we just taking a walk.
Yeah.
That's really what happened. I just summed it up for you guys. But she had to be in the NICU for like, how long? Like 2-3 days.
Yeah.
And we had to keep walking down to get her. She was on oxygen and heat. She couldn't do a lot of things on her own for a while. They had a lot of fluids inside of her. So they had a lot of fluids inside of her. Like in the hospital, I felt happy. Like I felt happy to have my baby. I guess it was just in the way I had her, it was kind of sad. And when I got home, it's like I looked at my other kids and it made me feel like I'm neglecting them. So it's making it a little hard on me. And then we have like, this is our first time on our own, like we keep telling y'all, so it's like really stressful. I know it's not gonna happen right away. Our mindset is always like, you gotta start somewhere and you're gonna go through hard times and that's how you get to the top. You're not just gonna start off and just be the richest person in the world with the best people you wanna be around. It's not gonna be like that. So
bobbing and weaving.
So we're going through it and I know it's gonna get better, but right now it's like really stressful and sad, especially with a lot of other things going on.
Yeah,
it's just making me think. It's kind of scary because we're young and it was like we prayed on times like this but never really thought it was gonna happen because of how much hope we lost. But we got it, and now we have to cope together and become a team and get used to it.
That's right. Honey Boo Boo saying the truth. Come on, come on. It's just
stop, babe.
It's just gonna be a raw footage. Yeah. Unedited, uncut, because we just want y'all to feel where we coming from. We don't want to put no fake moments in there. Let me stop. Maybe a little, not a lot.
But yeah. I'm taking these pills, guys, and it gave me a freaking rash.
Yeah.
So if I see something,
I thought she had the H.
Stop, don't even say that. I got like this skin rash where I broke out in the morning. It's all in my nose, my lip, all on my nose. So, oh, they're playing pool.
We don't know how to play pool.
Yes, I do. You don't.
We got a computer room. Mm-hmm.
I can't wait to get better.
Michael Johnson.
Woo! Got it on time. Just in time. I want to sit on a bench, but I don't think I can.
Oh, it's me.
Y'all, you don't understand. I love swimming.
Yeah.
I actually really do. I used
can't
to
swim.
Every summer, I would be at the beach or the pool almost every fucking day. Every day. And now, can't swim for like a month and a half.
It's okay. We both won't swim.
You don't like swimming, though. We actually have access to the pool. Do you know how excited I was to hear that we had a pool?
Two.
Yes.
I thought we just had one. Push the button.
Cool. Oh, now you scared of them?
No, I was seeing what it was. Yo, there's so many flies all over the room.
Good for me to walk. Yeah, it helps a little bit better.
What?
I haven't really walked out here at night. It's nice.
Mm-hmm. Well, we about to go back in the house and just relax and watch some movies.
Yeah, we got our show back on, y'all. Black Lightning. And we're also watching Manifest.
Yeah, I forgot about that. You still gotta watch that.
And there's a new movie, Kevin Hart, and then now everybody's talking about, you have to watch that on Netflix. Y'all tune in, you're putting y'all on.
What?
Y'all don't watch Black Lightning, I don't know what y'all missing.
Let me check and see if the clothes is dry.
Casanova. I don't even care if you drunk or you sober.